No stupid questions. Do astronauts masturbate when they are in space? I watched a vid and someone asked that in a live stream and they can't do that sadly. Doggy style and reverse cowgirl are the same position in space. From the book Packing for Mars by Mary Roach. Greater than in a memoir, astronaut Michael Collins relates a story of a physician back in the Apollo era who recommended regular masturbation on long missions, lest astronauts develop prostate infections. The flight surgeon for Collins's moon mission decided to ignore that advice, and ignoring seems to have been the basic approach to the human sex drive ever since. It's the same way at the Russian Space Agency. Cosmonaut Alexander Lavakin told me he too had heard that lengthy abstinence could cause prostate infections, but that the space agency pretends the issue doesn't exist. It's up to yourself how you will deal with it. But everybody is doing it, everybody understands. It's nothing. My friends ask me, how are you making sex in space? I say, by hand. As for the logistics, there are possibilities. And sometimes it happens automatically while you sleep. It's natural. John Charles told me he'd heard about the link between prostate health and self-stim at NASA. There's an abbreviation for everything but never heard any formal discussion, pro or con, of orbital masturbation. Interestingly, they do have a pregnancy tester up there, so I can't imagine that NASA has not tested human sexual function in space. NASA has run extensive physiological tests for long-term space living, trips to Mars, etc. No way they ignore human sexuality and reproduction. No way. I know that official policy was no one has ever had sex in space. Just wondering if that counts in the statement. And hashtag X200B. Edit, well, I went from less than 200 karma this morning to greater than 2300 now. I'm both amazed and terrified. Is the force of an ejaculation sufficient for zero gravity propulsion? The official answer is no. I guarantee you somebody's tried it, though. People have asked that. The answer is no. I don't know how they do it. Would be fun with no gravity and all. Like, you're just flying around in ISS and forgot to close the door to the bedroom, and you get slapped in the face by a chunk of sperm. They probably do, but I doubt anyone will go on record saying they have. Horniness is a thing in outer space. Back in 2017, there was a headline about sending all women teams to space to prevent intercourse between astronauts. This was like Reddit's top question for Chris Hadfield when he did his AMA. His response was something like, "The ISS is very big. Bigger than most people realize. It is not difficult to find privacy when you want it. When you nut in space, it push you back." Vsauce and other YouTube channels have gone on record about the general topic of sex in space and how it is basically impossible. Gravity affects the blood flow, causing blood to collect in your head and torso. It's almost impossible for a male astronaut to achieve and maintain an erection because of this. Similarly, it is nearly impossible for a woman to get aroused because the blood flow has a hard time getting to her clitoris. Even if this was solved, there is still a problem with opposing forces and motion. Sex would be nearly impossible because both partners would be pushing their partner in the opposite direction and into objects around them. The more they try to stay together, the greater the force pushing them apart. This is why long-distance space flights are so problematic and why generation ships to go to other star systems are currently impossible. My guess is not in the conventional sense, but they get so goddamn horny they nut in a split second, probably on that gizmo that suckers their piss out into space. Yes. I saw it in Letterkenny. They shoot their batch into a cone or else it would float around with them. Yes, some URL. I guess it would be the same until you ejaculated. 9 out of 10 do. The other astronaut is lying. They don't masturbate. They big bang. They have Kleenex in space. There is not going to be any sperm floating around. Inquiring minds want to know. I'm pretty sure they do. Some say no because of live streaming. I quit that means because they aren't always live streaming. But they are human, so I'm 96% sure they do. Among all the joke responses, I'll offer a perspective as someone who was in the military. Dunno if other guys experienced the same, but this was what it was like for me anyway. At boot camp, there's rumors that they put something in the food to keep us from getting boners. As if being around hundreds of other dudes, for straight guys anyway, wasn't enough of a deterrence. And I never felt the urge to jack off for the whole 3 months I was there. Then even after boot camp, for a good couple of years I just didn't really have a particularly high libido. Not sure if it was because of the constant training, and again being around other dudes all the time, or maybe they were still putting stuff in our food. But I never really felt much of an urge to masturbate. I mean, I could if I wanted to. And during Liberty Ports, if I hooked up with some lady, I was more than able and willing to engage in intercourse. But once it was back to the trenches, I once again never felt a strong need for sexual release. I then went on deployment where I was on duty 12 hours on and 12 hours off. I was always busy, and when I was off shift, I hit up the gym, got some food, and hit the rack to get as much sleep as possible before my next shift. I did this for 6 months straight and also never felt particularly horny. My theory is that the constant work and physical training probably kept me exhausted along with being around other dudes all the time again. Then finally, my last year of my enlistment, I picked up rank to where I no longer had a roommate. Got a bit of a raise and didn't go eat at the troop chow hall as often, opting to buy my own food, and relaxed my training standards a bit since I was getting ready to discharge. I noticed at this point, I was back to normal. I was still living on base and there wasn't much pussy out in town in the middle of nowhere near the base I was stationed at. So as soon as Friday came around, I got myself alcohol, locked myself up in my room and would jack off 3, 4, or more times over the course of a day. That was pretty much my routine until I eased. Once I got back to the civilian world, hooked up with regular women, my libido completely returned to normal. So anyway, I'd imagine NASA astronauts might go through a similar experience. If I recall correctly, they're only up there for a year at most. My experience in the military was over the course of several years in my late 20s. A lot of the astronauts tend to be in their 30s already, so they probably have more of a handle on their libido than some horny 20-year-olds. They cannot. Without gravity, it is impossible to build high enough blood pressure to get an erection. I'm not sure about women though. Looks like I'm never going to space. I mean, privacy isn't something you get a lot of on the ISS. Does your cum float around? If it does, I see why you wouldn't. The orgasms last longer in Uranus. I saw a Chris Hadfield interview where he said their entire day is planned out in like 5-minute intervals. It sounds like they'd hardly have the opportunity to do so even if they were allowed. That and what happens once the guy shoots his load? Now you've got space jizz floating around up there. Complete disaster. I didn't and then got that erectile pain that always happens when you don't masturbate for a long time. The muscles that support the penis get weak. All anti-masturbation freaks do not get that condition. They just do it secretly, and maybe feel some shame. What the fuck do you think astronauts do all day? Deleted. Can't believe everyone is like, no, where would the jizz go? Forgetting that people with vulvas and clits are also astronauts. No problem flicking the bean in zero G. Be easier to swallow, just open your mouth, it just floats right in. My understanding is that the zero gravity in space makes the necessary blood circulation required for an erection to be impossible. We've reached Uranus. They only masturbate. Hungry face. Kulchuk feeds up Oswom. Technically we all are in space, so yes. Do they breathe? Of course they do. What person doesn't masturbate? No, they have female astronauts there too in case they need to throw a boner. Am I like the only man alive who does not masturbate? I know how it works, but I am just not into it. What about a no homo bro blow? Because sometimes a guy needs his astronaut. My best guess would be that zero G makes it very difficult to become erect. I'm not a scientist, but that's my educated guess. Yes. But after a while the zero gravity makes it like living in a snow globe. Apologies for stealing that from Family Guy. If they did after a few sessions, it would be like living inside a snow globe. Whitney Houston, we have a problem. Yeah, you just do your batch into a cone. Unless you're trying to pull a prank, then you just batch without a cone. Imagining spooge in zero G. When you nut in space, it push you back. They do, but they have to chomp the cum out the air like Pac-Man. When you nut in space, it pushes you backwards. I can guarantee you the first man in space was the first man to jack off in space. Yuri knew exactly what he was achieving when he took his pecker out. I really think of unsubbing this subreddit. You can do that, but NASA won't allow it. Here's how it might be done. When you done fapping, some sperm will come, some don't. You can vacuum flush some which came out, and other you have to squeeze it out like toothpaste. Then you have to pee to clean up urinary tract. Problems. Not so serious, but it's waste of resource to clean up sperm, and smell of sperm in whole lab. No, of course not. That is why they started sending women into space. Women can definitely get away with it, so if anybody is lying, it's them. Guys have incriminating loads to worry about. Even if it's not allowed, do it anyway. What are they gonna do? Come and get you? No, 'cause they're not fucking losers, you weirdo. You know she's a whore when she floats over to recycle it.